Hello, in this video I'd like to show how the TMUX program works. TMUX is a shell multiplexer, whatever that means. That's basically a way to do in your shell pains, tabs, and like save a session and then come back to it later. And a way to, if you have TMUX on a remote machine, to have a like a whole session but stored on the remote where you can like detach it, disconnect and then connect to it later, or if your connection crashes to like get back where you were in your shell. So it's quite a useful utility. And yeah, so to install it, you do apt install TMUX or whatever your package manager is if you don't use Ubuntu. And to launch it, you do TMUX. And as you can see at the bottom, we have a small status bar, and but the rest is just a regular shell where you can type stuff. And so the way you run commands or you manipulate TMUX is with shortcuts, but it's a bit specific because every single commands in every single action you can do in TMUX, the shortcut is actually prefixed with something, and by default it's Control B. So you press Control B and then something. So let's say I want to create a new window. So it would be Control B C, Control B C. Yeah, I didn't do fa it fast enough. But you see now I have a new tab. But you have to press Control B. But Control B is annoying, so the first thing I would recommend is to actually change this. And for this, you go in tmux.conf in your home directory. In my case, it's a bit more complicated. I have to go into tmux to use this. And as you can see, I set the default binding to Control A instead, which is way easier on the fingers. And I would also recommend, if you don't want to learn some too much shortcuts, to enable this option, which is set the mouse so that you can select a tab or a pane like you usually do in terminals that have this feature. But besides that, yeah, you can see that it's quite customizable. You can have plugins and so on. So let's set that and then go back in TMUX. And so let's do some commands. And what I was talking in the beginning about like remote session and so on is that let's say I don't know, my terminal crashes or something, and TMUX will detach this session. So what you have right now is a session, and if you do Control A D, it will detach the session. But if you do TMUX LS, you can see that it still exists. And you can like do stuff in your life or whatever. And then you can do TMUX attach. And you will go back to the state your shell was in. So this is yeah, quite useful to keep your work somewhere. Next is creating a pane. So here you only have one pane, but you can create, let's say, a vertical pane. So that's with a percentage shortcut, which, yeah, weird shortcut. Don't worry about it. So Control A ampersand, and that's now you have two panes next to each other. To navigate between panes, to like cycle through them, you can do prefix O. So you see I'm switching here and there, here and there. And to create a horizontal pane, you do Control A and then double colon. No, not double colon, double quote. And here you can have a pane here. And still you can switch between them like this. And you can rearrange the pane order with space. So prefix, wait, no, prefix space, and you see it switches the order of them. And yeah, back to where we were. You also have tabs, or as TMUX calls them windows. So it's prefixes C to create a new window where you can create a bunch of splits or panes if you want. To cycle through windows, you do Control N. Then yeah. For the basics, that's pretty much all you need, I think. And yeah, you can like detach it and then TMUX A to attach, and then boom, you're back where you were. And yeah, it's quite convenient, especially if your terminal doesn't have like built-in panes or tabs. Yeah. And especially for remote, it's very, very useful. And yeah, that's it. Feel free to explore it as you want, but yep. Anyway, see you.